Invisible maze. How do you make one? Okay, if you think, there's two types of squares here. There's this one that you can't walk on, and there's this one that you can. Right? And they're all covered in carpet. So the place you can walk, it's got a wooden block on it. The place you can't walk, it's got a fence. It's as simple as that. Okay, because the fence pretends to be a block that's 1.5 blocks high. So you can't step on it because the roof's too high. Okay, but it's only actually 1 block high. So if you cover this lot with carpet, you can't actually tell the difference. But the game is convinced that it is different. It's convinced that you can't go there because that block is too high. It's like there's a slab on top of it that's stopping you from getting in there because there's not enough headspace. And it's as simple as that. So you can go certain directions, but you can't go in others. I mean, I would love to have claimed I was the person who thought that up. Lots of other people have thought it up. But thank you. But I think that was a... Oh, it was just a little bit of fun. That was good. And there we go. The fireworks had gone down, so I think a few people have gone through it. Let's just set up a firework. Boom. Actually, that reminds me. If you guys are hearing explosions in the background, it's bonfire night. Guy Fawkes night in the United Kingdom. And it's the day when we celebrate the fact that somebody failed to blow up Parliament by setting off lots of fireworks. So I excuse the sound. Bit of cake. I think I've gone through this maze more than everyone. Close. Open. There we go. Thank you. So there you go. That's how I made the maze. And I'm going to be tearing this down fairly soon. But we decided we're going to keep this little area. They are fun, aren't they? We're going to keep this little area and we're going to reserve it for seasonal stuff. So we'll probably do something there. I should imagine we'll do something there for Christmas, for example. So, right. What else is new? What else is... Hello there. Hello, Ben Ballantyne 442. Street. Who else haven't I said hello to? I think I've said hello to everyone. If I haven't said hello to you, shout out and I'll try again. Yeah. It's all nice. Okay, so... This is Sims 3 Simulator's house. He's done an excellent job. Of this, this is her first build. She's got some pictures here that she's still thinking about places to put. In turkey maze, not a bad idea. hello Joe CO8, hello, and hello Kaylee, hello, and welcome all to the stream. So, alright, okay, you go up here like this, here we go. Right, and there's some upstairs rooms, and a bedroom. Okay. And yes, it actually has. It's gone quite nice outside. Single digit figures. Oh, I didn't realize you get such a nice view of the pumpkin from here. Look at that.
Okay.
Yeah, right. But still, I like that. That was fun to build and it just looks so good. And I think this isn't going to look too bad when it's finished. We just need to get lots of bushes and plants and perhaps some gravel paths going through here. I want to put a little island here and perhaps a couple of little bridges across. Places for people to sit. Yeah, it's not looking too bad. Right, what are we going to do next? I thought I was just going to dress in red, to be honest with you. Yes, she has. She's working very hard on that, I think, and done an excellent job. Interesting. Very interesting. My Minecraft just doesn't like this corner. And how very odd. I'm sorry, I can't let anyone on the server. It's invitation only, and we're very, very strict about who we let on. Nothing personal about anyone, and we're not going to say no to anyone because we're not going to say yes to anyone. It's as simple as that. Right, so let's get rid of some of this junk. Okay, I'll probably have to look into that. Let's get rid of this. Do I need... Yeah, I need another pickaxe. Let's grab another pickaxe quickly. Because that one's about dead. Hey, Meteor99, hello, welcome to the stream. Another one of those. That. Broken one away. I forgot I had that. Go on, Shizzy. Okay, I tell you what. If you make me one, I guarantee you I will wear it and I'll record me wearing it. How's that? Fished that the other day. Power 3 bow. Very nice. Lovely stuff. What am I missing? Shovel. I'm not going to need that where I'm going. Let's get out of here. Alright, I'm going to go to the nether. And that's probably going to be where we're doing some working tonight. So I just want to stock up on some cobblestone because I just want to lay something out. And we're going to pop over there. Cobblestone. Oh, don't have much cobblestone here anymore. Let's go back inside and get some. Hey. Oh, sorry about that. Somebody decided that sending me a text was a good idea at this time. Yay them. Right, cobblestone. Where's cobblestone? Cobblestone's over here. How can I fail to find my way around these 40,000 different boxes? Get a bit of this stuff. There we go. To start. Right, let's pop over to the nether. Get cracking there. And to Simon. Ho ho ho! Yeah, right. Okay. I fished that the other day. I fished a lily pad. Never fished a lily pad before. I didn't know you could. I tell you what, Shizzy, okay? If you make me a Damien skin, I promise you I will wear that as well, okay? Right. Very nice.
I'll even do the voice while wearing it. Well, if you insist. There's Nuggets. There's Nuggets' girlfriend.
And a lot has happened over here while we were... since we were last here together. Over there is I'm a Mage's build. She calls it the donut. We'll probably go and have a look there. But I think what he's done with this railway is probably going to be the design we're going to have for the entire railway system. The only thing I don't like about it is he's opted to make it unlit, which I don't think I particularly want.
Damien doesn't go down chimneys. Damien goes through windows.
Let's, what the hell? Let's go for a little ride, shall we? here we go. Beach. welcome to the stream. Here we are, Screech. The other end. I actually really do like the look here. Like the blue glass, like the bricks. And through here there's a load of blaze spawners. Basically he's just built it over a fortress, which is, it makes a lot of sense to me. The slabs don't, no, they stop mobs from spawning on the railway line though. Yeah, I think, I'm a mage, did a great job there. There we go. And this is the donut. And there's a lot still needs to be done on this.
So tell me, little girl, have you been naughty? Or have you been nice?
Somebody's killed themselves a wither. Beacon going on here. Yeah, if we can work a toddler into that, lore will basically just explode, you're right. Ooh, he's done a lot of work down here since I was last here. Own little farm, little enchanting area. Yes, lots of stuff. Vine farm, lots of crops. Hey, looks nice. Alright, okay, so he's clearly being very, very busy. Regeneration? Ah, nice, okay. Nice, nice, nice. Explains why we don't see him spawn much anymore. Okay. Oh, how do we get up here? I see. There we go. Okay, right, what I want to do is I'm going to show you guys around the stuff that's been built around the Nether and the places we've gone to from the Nether, and it shouldn't take too long. And I appreciate we've been streaming for a little bit. Haven't actually done that much yet. Oh, there's a mob farm up there. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to go grab some sand quickly. And then what we'll do is we'll start looking at the build of this way. We'll start looking at the build of the train station in the Nether, because what I want to do is flesh that out a bit with you guys. And we'll start moving that forward, because I've promised people that I'd do that, and I like just about every other build, I haven't actually got around to it yet, because oh, so yeah. Okay, great, great job in getting rid of the pigman there. Oi, you got any friends nearby? No. Just die. Perhaps I shouldn't fight anything when wearing a half set of leather armor, I don't know. Right. Get you onto the rails, there we go. I've no idea, but he's probably spawned on the stairs there. Personally, I think we need to go through and just light this out. Eek. Right, so there we go. We're back here. Back at the train station. Okay, this is going to be the central area of the train station. And I'm not going to make it too big. I just want to make it sort of a circular area. Okay, and so we'll extend it out there. And then we'll start the railway lines going off in each direction. And I just actually, what I want to do is just start building out some of this tunnel as well. Just make it look good. Okay, just a little bit of it. and then we'll start just start expanding it out, and at the same time working on the railway track. But at the moment, this just looks horrible, really, doesn't it? We did it in a bit of a hurry, and it got us where we needed to go, which was great. But it just looks terrible. Yeah, pigmen don't aggro unless you hit one of them. And if you can insta-kill it, it doesn't matter. You can go around and kill every other pigmen in the game, and no pigmen will react whatsoever. But if a pigmen does see you, does hear that first pigmen being hit, it cries out, then everyone within shock becomes aggro, which is a pain. Doubly so when you're wearing leather armor, because it's next to no damage resistance whatsoever. So why do I wear it? Why do I wear it? Because it looks so damn good. That's why I wear it. Look at me. Man, I'm looking excellent. Okay, I'm a mage, and the Hell Kitty went exploring the other day, and they found something a bit fun, which we're just about coming up to the entrance to. Yes, you see, okay, these guys didn't hear the shout. They don't particularly care about me. Stock up on me chicken there. Yes. Model of a perfect gentleman in leather armor. Mostly because I can't find enough chainmail. So, run down here, and this is all looking horrible. I just wanna redo this area. I just wanna do this area, to be totally honest with you. Suave, yes. Make it a bit gas-proof, get the railway line sorted out on it, and so on. Oi, you, get out of the way, coming through. I'm so glad we can run through the nether. This is a long run. Just think how long this run would be if we had to do it on the surface. It would be just so painful. All right. Tell you what, okay, while we're doing this, let's have a bit of a question and answer session. If you guys want to ask me something, feel free to do so. I reserve the right not to answer questions about my personal life, but within reason, I'll answer anything you want to ask me. So, here we go. We found a mushroom island, or at least I'm a mage, and Hell Kitty found a mushroom island. Which is nice. This is where we got the mycelium from, which I showed you guys earlier on. Just one of the rarer biomes, and we've got mushrooms here. Make a quick crafting bench. Yep. And so tell me, Mandarin Moon, do you now have the song going through your head? Favorite game ever? Hard one to answer, but I'd in all honesty say the Thief series. I think I've played that more than anything else. Hello. Back here. Okay, I'll dance on that block. Up to you. Come back here. Mushroom stew. Yeah. And something I learned by accident, I didn't know you could do this. You can milk mushrooms as well. Right, let's do something completely out of character and pick this up. Okay, so last weekend we all got a bit bored and decided we wanted a bit of an adventure. So we thought we'd try out one of these new... Here. Yeah. I think I might be wrong. It might not be the 5th of November. There might be a war starting out there. those mushrooms are fantastic. So yeah, we decided to try one of these underwater temples, which we did, and there was lots of death and screaming and green runny bits. It was fun. Do I play games off camera? Yeah, I do.